السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تأكلوا أموالكم بينكم بالباطل إلا أن تكون تجارة عن تراض منكم. وعن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: التاجر الصدوق الأمين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء، أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. Honorable ulama, respected elders and dear brothers in Islam, yes, we are in a month which to many is the end of a financial year and the starting of a new financial year. Many a business enterprise, many a financial institute treats this month of April as the end of a financial year, March 31st being the end of the year and April 1st being the starting of a new financial year. And therefore, in many a business enterprise, stocks are taken, the profits are evaluated, profits are looked into, turnover is looked into, it's compared with the last year to see that how much more profit or how much less profit have I made this year. And many an employee working will have received his bonus too, and some might be content with the bonus and the salary raise, and some might not be content with the bonus received and the salary which is raised. But my dear respected elders and brothers, the question each and every one of us need to ask ourselves is, in this past financial year, have I been a good businessman? Have I been a businessman that has pleased Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Have I been a businessman who is praised by Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Or have I been one who is reprimanded by Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Some of us sitting here might think that business is a means of earning money and feeding ourselves and our children. And that's it. It's got nothing to do with religion and nothing to do with Islam. No, my dear respected elders and brothers. Earning is a commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's compulsory upon each and every man, each and every male. Earning is compulsory upon him, wherein Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, طلب كسب الحلال فريضة بعد الفريضة. That earning of wealth which is halal is from amongst the obligations. So it's obligatory upon each and every male that he looks into the financial matters of his wife and children. And moreover, Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam categorizes the types of businessmen, wherein in one hadith Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions, التاجر الصدوق الأمين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء. That a businessman, a person who earns, who is truthful and trustworthy, on the day of Qiyamah, he'll be amongst Anbiya alayhim as-salam, he'll be amongst the prophets and those who have attested, or those who have been truthful, and he'll be amongst those who are the martyrs. But at the same time, on another occasion, Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whilst passing by a group of people, group of sahaba who were involved in business, Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya ma'ashara tujjar, O you businessmen, O you people who are involved in your dealings. So the sahaba replied, they turned away from whatever they were doing and they turned to Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, Inna tujjara yuba'athuna yawm al-qiyamati fujjaran illa man ittaqa Allah wa barra wa sadaqa. That tujjar, businessman, will be raised on the day of Qiyamah from amongst the transgressors. from amongst the evildoers, from amongst those who have wronged Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except ones who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except the ones who are pious, and except the ones who say the truth. So my dear respected elders and brothers, when we look into the ahadith of Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we see that businessmen are characterized into two groups. One being those who will be resurrected amongst the Anbiya alayhi salam, amongst the prophets. And the second being those who will be resurrected amongst transgressors and those who have done wrong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So today in our lecture, let us look at those qualities that would put me into the group, or into among that would resurrect me amongst those people who will be resurrected amongst Anbiya alayhim salam, and those qualities which I would refrain from that would resurrect me amongst the fujjar, amongst the fasiqs, amongst the transgressors. From amongst the qualities, number one is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَأْكُلُوا أَمْوَالَكُمْ بَيْنَكُمْ بِالْبَاطِلِ إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ تِجَارَةً عَن تَرَاضٍ مِّنْكُمْ. That whatever dealing we have, whatever way we earn money, لَا تَأْكُلُوا أَمْوَالَكُمْ بَيْنَكُمْ بِالْبَاطِلِ. Do not usurp the wealth of another in a way which is incorrect, in the incorrect manner. Do not gain the wealth of another in the incorrect manner. إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ تِجَارَةً. Except when there is a deal, when there is a tijara, when there is a bay, when there is a transaction in which a commodity is involved, or in which some kind of labor is involved, where you're getting money in lieu of a commodity or in lieu of any service provided. Money should not be gotten in any other manner. إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ تِجَارَةً عَن تَرَاضٍ مِّنْكُمْ. Even this deal, this transaction that we're having, should be with contentment of both parties. Both parties should be content with the business or with the dealing that is happening. Now, in this ayah also tells us that earning money in a way which is incorrect is wrong. And that one of the ways in which money is earned in an incorrect way is through interest. That's why many a place in the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids us from interest. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَحَلَّ اللَّهُ الْبَيْعَ وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَى. Transactions, business dealings have been made halal. They have been made permissible. But interest has been made haram. It is impermissible. So much so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in another verse says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَىٰ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fear Allah and keep away from interest. And if you do not, if you cannot keep away from interest, then you have declared war. فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. You have declared war with Allah and His Rasul. So my dear respected elders and brothers, one of the incorrect ways of acquiring wealth, one of the ways that would put us amongst those who will be resurrected amongst the transgressors, is that we acquire wealth through interest. And when it comes to interest, it's not only about giving interest, or it's not only about taking interest, it's also about giving interest. Wherein Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لعن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم آكل الربا وموكله وشاهديه وكاتبه. Person taking interest is also cursed by the Nabi of Allah. Person giving interest to another is also cursed by the Nabi of Allah. But the two people witnessing an interest-bearing transaction are also cursed by the Nabi of Allah. And person writing down the transaction of interest is also cursed by the Nabi of Allah. So my dear respected elders and brothers, it's not only about taking. We think that the interest money that comes in, many people ask a question, they put out a query, that how do I get rid of the interest money that I have acquired? I ask them the question, how did you acquire that interest money? You being in that interest bearing dealing itself is haram. You being in a transaction where you promise that if I delay in payment, I will pay interest, that dealing itself is haram. And it's not only about taking interest, even an interest-bearing loan. We've taken a loan from the bank for which we're paying interest, that is haram. This is one of the means for us to be amongst the fujjar on the day of Qiyamah. So any relationship with interest has been said haram by Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wasallam, whether it be the person taking interest, giving interest, witnessing interest, or writing down a transaction of interest. So the first quality that we should have in us is that any wealth acquired should be through a transaction, through a transaction which is permissible in the eyes of Sharia. So for that we should look into business in Sharia. There's books and books written on Islamic finance or laws of business in Islam. When you take any book of Islamic jurisprudence, there is a big portion of it which mentions the laws of business. For example, we cannot sell something until it has come into our possession. Did we all know about it? Likewise, there are many other laws for which one Jummah ban, I would say even 10 Jummah bans are not enough. We should go to the ulama, we should go to the scholars of Islam and learn business by them. It was the practice of our pious predecessors that they would go to the bazaars, they would go to the marketplaces and send everyone to the mosque, tell them you learn about business, then come and do business. It's compulsory upon us. On the day of Qiyamah, we cannot make an excuse that, oh Allah, I did not know. So let us first learn what is the correct way of earning money and what's the incorrect way of earning money. So that's the first quality, that we should earn money in the correct way to be amongst Anbiya on the day of Qiyamah. The second quality mentioned in the hadith itself is to say the truth. The hadith says, "At-tajiru saduqul amin," a businessman who's truthful. Now this word saduq in Arabic differs from the word sadiq. The word sadiq means a person who says the truth once. And saduq means a person who always says the truth. The meaning of continuity comes in the word saduq. So a person who always says the truth, a tajir, a businessman who always says the truth. Not that, okay, 90% of my business I say the truth, but for 10%, I you can't do business without lying. So, you know, I'll lie in that 10%. No, that's not the person Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is referring to. He should be a saduq. He should say the truth at all times. That's why in another hadith, Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Al-bayyi'ani bil-khiyar ma lam yatafarraqa fa'in sadaqa wa bayyina burika lahuma fi bay'ihima wa in kadaba wa katama muhiqat barakatu bay'ihima." That when two people are doing a transaction, a business transaction, if both of them have said the truth, sadaqa wa bayyina, they have disclosed or they have made apparent of the faults in the goods that they have, they are very clear about their business. So Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said they'll get barakah in their transaction. There'll be barakat in their bayya. But at the same time, فَإِن كَذَبَا, if both of them are lying and both of them are hiding things from each other, then Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says their business is destroyed. مُحِقَتْ بَرَكَةُ بَيْعِهِمَا. No barakah in their business. However much they earn, they would not prosper through their earnings. So my dear respected elders and brothers, the sifa of truthfulness, come what may, let us be truthful. And in truthfulness in all aspects, it's not only when doing the transaction, when labeling the goods that we're selling. Sometimes we label them with branded names when they are not branded. We say made in so and so country when they are obviously made in another country. Some people get clever, they instead of made in, they put made as. But let us try not to lie in any way, whether it be in any part of our business, in our labeling, in describing our goods, in what you call, in promising the other as to how quickly we'll make the payment. In every aspect of life, let us keep away from lying, because lying will put us from amongst the fujjar, transgressors, and being truthful will raise us from amongst the anbiya alayhim salam. The third quality, my respected elders and brothers, also mentioned in that very same hadith, at-tajiru saduqul amin, to be trustworthy. We should do business in a way that people trust us. That people know, okay, if I buy my goods by this person, I know that I'm getting quality goods. If I sell my goods to this person, if he says 1 month, his money is coming in 1 month. If he says 2 months, I know I'm going to receive my payments in 2 months. Yes, there might be ups and downs where that person is facing a loss, etc. But generally, I know this person, he'll give back my money on time. That quality should come in us. Today, sadly, we see that it's amongst us Muslims that this quality is lost. Very sad to say, in a majmua, in a gathering of Muslims, that some non-Muslims possess these qualities. Where we say, no, if I deal with this person is trustworthy. I don't have to worry about the goods. Goods are going to be as spoken. Or I don't have to worry about the money. Money is, even his checks are like cash. But very rarely such words are spoken about Muslims nowadays in the bazaar. We go to the marketplace, even the non-Muslims are blaming the Muslims. You ask them, where's our payment? You say, your people, they are the ones who are not paying us. How can we pay you? This is not the quality of Muslims. Muslims are supposed to be trustworthy, wherein they have trust in us. And say, no, if I give him the goods, I know I'm going to receive the money on time. Today, on the contrary, Muslims say, no, I'm not going to run away with your money, I'll give it to you. But you told me 2 months, it's only 3 months now. I mean, in 6 months' time, you'll get your money. That's not the quality of a Muslim. So my respected elders and brothers, a quality that will resurrect us from amongst the Anbiya alayhi salam is to be trustworthy. That people have trust in us. People give us goods, they're at ease. They sleep in peace. People, we owe money to people, or people buy goods from us, they're at ease, quality is guaranteed. Or people order goods from us, they know they'll get what they have ordered. That quality should come in us Muslims. Fourth quality, my respected elders and brothers, mentioned in that hadith, is wherein Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِلَّا مَنِ اتَّقَ اللَّهَ وَبَرَّ وَصَدَقَ. That tujjar, businessmen, will be resurrected from amongst the fasiqeen, from amongst the transgressors, except those who fear Allah and are pious. We should have this quality of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That one day, whatever I say, whatever I do, one day I'll have to face Allah. Allah is watching me. I'm doing business, Allah is watching me. If I'm lying, Allah is watching me. If I'm cheating my brother Muslim, Allah is watching me. This quality has to come in us. Today, the greatest fear that we have is, what will people say? What are people going to say if I do this? What are people going to say if I do that? No, the fear that should come into us is, what is Allah going to say? How is Allah going to deal with me on the day of Qiyamah if I do such and such a deed? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, just try fearing me and you see what you get. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. That ones who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open up ways for him. Not one way, not two ways, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I'll open up ways for him. Just try fearing me and you see how much barakah you have in your wealth. Try fearing me and you see how much income you have compared to what you had before. The fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَخْتَسِبْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that Allah will feed us from places that we could never ever imagine. That's the barakah of taqwa. Fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my dear respected elders and brothers in Islam, these are just but a few of the qualities that Muslims should possess. Few of the qualities that Muslim businessmen, as Muslims that are earning money, the qualities that we should possess, that we should earn money in the correct way shown to us by Islam. We should earn money by being truthful. We should earn money by being trustworthy. And we should earn money whilst having the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we take taqwa, it encompasses everything. Taqwa means that we abide by the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and refrain from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited. So it encompasses everything. And my dear respected elders and brothers, many of us might have had prophets which we might be content with. Some of us might have had prophets which we were not content with. But my dear respected elders and brothers, let us understand that prosperity does not depend on how much we earn. Prosperity depends on how content we are with what we earn. That's why Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions that laysa al-ghina kathratul ard walakin al-ghina ghina an-nafs. That prosperity is not having excessive wealth, but prosperity is being content in our hearts. So whatever profits we got, whatever bonus we got this year, whatever raise in salary we got this year, let us be content. Alhamdulillah. Allah has given me this much, I am happy. Inshallah, Allah will give me barakah in this. And it's not about how much we have, it's about how much barakah we have. And that barakah will come through taqwa. That barakah will come through tawakkul. That is, we have trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Those who have tawakkul, trust in Allah, Allah is enough for them. Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, لَوْ أَنَّكُمْ تَوَكَّلْتُمْ عَلَى اللَّهِ حَقَّ تَوَكُّلِهِ لَرَزَقَكُمْ كَمَا يَرْزُقُ الطَّيْرِ تَغْدُو خِمَاسًا وَتَرُوحُ بِطَانًا. That if any one of us has to have tawakkul in Allah, trust in Allah like Allah has to be trusted, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will feed us like He feeds the birds. The birds, they go out empty stomach, they come back full stomach. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also feed us in this way. So my dear respected elders and brothers, like we have taken account of our stock, like we have looked into how much profits we have made and what our turnover is for this year, etc., etc., let us also look into these aspects, that how many qualities of a businessman that have I got in myself that would resurrect me amongst the Anbiya alayhimus salam, and how many qualities have I got that would resurrect me amongst the fujjar, amongst the transgressors. If I possess any of the qualities that would resurrect me amongst the transgressors, let me this year stay away from these qualities. And if I, whatever qualities I possess or I don't possess which will resurrect me amongst the Anbiya alayhimus salam, let me inculcate those qualities this year. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give each and every one of us the tawfiq to make amal upon what has been said. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make each and every one of us those who acquire the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who do business by acquiring the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who will be resurrected on the day of Qiyamah with Nabiyeen, Siddiqeen, Shuhada and Salihin. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin.